enjoyers and everyone watching church online today. We just want to say welcome to church. You know what, as enjoy church, we just want to let you know that we are praying for you and praying for your families. And we're praying that you're going to have a blessed day today. You know, we want to really encourage you as you watch online to be engaged. So whether it's watching at enjoy.church/online, you know, it's such a great time and such a great opportunity to be sharing the gospel with your family and friends by sharing that link. Or if you're watching on Facebook, you can tag your friends, you can comment, you can share. There are so many ways to stay connected and stay engaged online today. So God bless you so much. Have a great Sunday and enjoy the service.
Welcome to Enjoy Church Online. It's so good to have you with us today. So wherever you are at home, I invite you to stand to your feet and praise the Lord with us. Amen. Come on. You paid the price on the cross for me. Now I'll never be the same. Give it all at a loss for free. I said I couldn't. Oh, Jesus, we praise your name. We lift you high. We lift you high in this place. We worship you, Father. I just want to encourage you, whatever situation you're facing, just to lift up your hands to heaven and face your eyes on Jesus. He's for you, he loves you, and he's here today for you. Amen. We worship you, Father. Thank you, Jesus.
Here in the stillness, where it all fades away, in your presence I'm found again. Here in the stillness, where a sin of your grace and my heart is made hold again. I am longing for your touch. Never needed it so much. I am longing for you again. Refresh my heart, refresh my soul. For only you can satisfy. Refresh my heart, refresh my soul. For only you.
Oh, come today with our alabaster jar. We break it upon your head, Jesus. You're worthy of our praise. We pour out our love and our adoration to you. We pour out our love and adoration to you. We love you, praise. We love you, God. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, God. Oh, we worship. Pour out our praise. Come on, church, let's sing this together. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. And great are you, Lord. You give life. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Sing, great are you, Lord, great are you, Lord. It's your
we'll be right back. Hey there, enjoyers. Well, we're going to come now around a time of tithes and offerings. You know, in a season like this, there's nothing better than we can be doing than giving. It is just absolutely the best thing, the best antidote for everything else that's going on in our world. You know, a while back I wrote a message and it really came out of Revelation 12 verse 11, where it says, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. You know, it's pretty incredible to think that God would put our word, our testimony, right up there next to the blood of the Lamb. And those two things together enable us to overcome. And I really want to encourage you today. You know, the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony, as we come into a place of giving into the house of God and into the things of God, we are really testifying to who is our Lord. I love actually how the Message version tells us. It says they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the bold word of their witness. You know, what we do, it witnesses to the fact that we are God's and that He is our Lord. And I really want to encourage you at this time as we're coming in and we're bringing our, basically our heart and our life to God. Let this be an extension of your worship to Him. Let it be your bold witness, your bold statement and testimony that God still reigns on the throne in your life. And as we do this, I know that God is just going to move in your life and He's going to move in the church life and He's going to use us to absolutely impact our community. And so I just want to, as we come now and bring that offering into the house, why don't we pray? Father, we thank you so much for your goodness. We thank you for your love. We thank you, Father, for your incredible faithfulness that we see day in and day out. Lord, I just pray for every person now as they give. Father, that you would bless them, that you would protect their household, Lord God, that you would watch over them and bring provision into their homes, Lord God. But Father, I thank you, Lord, for what we're doing. We're giving, we're testifying, we're declaring your lordship over our life. And Lord, we just pray that you would use what we bring, that your name would be glorified, that lives would be transformed, and that our community would be changed. Lord, we thank you so much for this opportunity to be a part of all you're doing on the earth right now. Lord, we love you and we bless you in Jesus' name. And everyone who agreed, why don't you say it with me? Amen.
Hey there, enjoyers, and welcome to Enjoy Online, but Church Online with the difference today, as we're streaming out of Pastor Shane and Georgie's home, which is very cool. So, but Aaron and I have had an opportunity over the last few months because of the roles that we're in to be in closer proximity with Pastor Shane and Georgie.
That's right. And we've seen overnight how you've transitioned into the lockdown period in terms of leading the church and how we do church. And it seems like now we're coming out of that season as some of the restrictions are eased and things are changing again, as they were already changing a lot, but now they're changing again. But we just wanted to ask you first, what is the best thing that you've enjoyed out of this season?
The best thing? Well, firstly, welcome to our home and welcome to our home, Enjoy Church and Raymond. Everybody loves Raymond. And so welcome everybody into our world and into our space. We just want to obviously take time today and just really talk about the now and moving forward. Some of the things that we've enjoyed, probably the thing that I've enjoyed the most, is maybe just slowing down enough to spend a little bit more time with the people I love, and it's been really cool. Some of the things that Georgie and I have enjoyed doing is just being able to go for a walk and grab a latte in the morning. We've walked more, I would think, in the last 6 weeks than we probably have in 31 years or whatever it is now. It's been great. It's been really wonderful. It's amazing to get out into your community and just walk and meet neighbours and let the dogs meet other dogs, and it's just been a really fun time. So walking with Georgie, I would say, as some of you are aware, Madison went and bought herself a house. She tells me she loves me, and then she goes and buys a house and moves out. What's that about? I got no idea, but that's what she did. But before Maddie left, we had an opportunity to spend some really quality time just on the couch here, just enjoying each other and laughing and just having a wonderful time there. But probably what I've enjoyed the most in regards to church world and this space of our life is seeing the resilience of the church. I got to tell you, it has overjoyed us to see the church in action together. As I speak about the church, obviously, I'm talking about the wider church, the global church. But in our hearts, obviously, our first place of love when it comes to church is Enjoy Church. And I got to tell you, you guys have been amazing, absolutely amazing. To see the church in action, to see the church working together, to see the church rise as one. And I'm not talking about just the leaders, I'm talking about the church. Yeah. From one end of the church to the other end of the church, wherever the church is gathering, it has been incredible to see brothers and sisters rising up. I have to give a big shout out. I'm just going to give some shout outs because, like, the reality is, so typically in the normal scheme of things, the board would meet every 2 to 3 months, typically every 2 months. But over this period, the board has met every Friday night. And so to the board, I just want to say thank you. We celebrate you. And for all that you are doing, unbelievable. You guys are incredible. The business team. So the board obviously are legally responsible for what we do. The business team are the ones that work with the government and other agencies that we might be compliant, because that's what we always want to be at Enjoy Church. We want to be legal. We want to be compliant. Make sure our governance is up to speed. The business team have worked overtime. They're like a machine in there, absolutely gone overtime. But then that is what you don't see happening, but that is happening every week. But then you've got friendship groups that are meeting every week. All of our friendship group leaders, just think about how much work that and how they've applied themselves. So for some of them, I don't even know if they knew what Zoom was. But now every week they're having Zoom meetings and they're including people in their space and in their world. And I just think it's amazing. So all of our friendship group leaders, our era leaders, praise God, wherever they may be, as our era leaders have done an incredible job. Kid Mania, look at Kid Mania. Kid Mania, you know, you know the song. It's unbelievable. It's wonderful to see what Kid Mania have done. It's wonderful to see what Empire has done. It's wonderful to see what the creative team. Obviously, we're here. You're receiving this today because we have an incredible creative team. Big shout out there. Some of you would have seen on social media, I left church one night at about 1 a.m. or whatever it was, and the worship team was still in there worshiping the house down. But the worship team do what they do. Behind the worship team, you have all the sound guys, the lighting guys. You guys were probably still on the cameras at that point in time and still on the cameras. It has been amazing. And so just to see the resilience of the church, we need to remember, and you've heard me say it many times before, Jesus said, I will build my church. Matthew 16:18, and I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. It's like, I just love that scripture because what we are seeing in reality now is Jesus is building his church. Yeah. You've heard me talk about that many, many times. And in this season, we are seeing what happens when men and women unite together. Jesus spoke that scripture to one man. His name is Peter. And you are Peter. That's what he said. Yeah. It's like, he's speaking to a man who had a revelation upon this rock. I will build my church. Yeah. And when brothers and sisters come together, when we all come together and unite our faith and our revelation and we work together, it's amazing what God can do. I want to remind you of another scripture. It's found in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 16. It says, from him, the whole body joined and held together by every supporting ligament grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. And that's what we've seen in this season. The church is resilient as each part does its work, and we are actually being built up during this time. That's what I love the most.
Oh, so good. Well, Pastor Georgie, what are you enjoying in this season?
Well, I've also really enjoyed the time as we've been out walking the dog, and that's been actually really lovely.
Romancing.
Of course, honey. You're romantic always. But it's just been, like, so it's actually been really nice to have time that's not pressured and just go for a walk, feel like you're just out and about, even though it's a great, you know, it leads into the rest of the day. We've still got the rest of the day, but it just feels nice. But the other thing I've also found is that it's actually quite an interesting season. I found it to be something that, you know, all the media and everything when it first started, and the social media was almost this sense of, like, we've got restrictions, we're getting locked down. And so everything's going to slow down. And so you've got to work out what you're going to do with all your time because you've got nothing to do. And it's that sense of slowing down, but actually it wasn't like that at all. It hasn't been slowing down. We're still not slowing down as such. But what I have really liked about it is it's actually kind of made me uncomfortable in a good way.
Yes.
And it's made me realise that I was quite comfortable in my routine, I was quite comfortable in myself, but I found that it's brought challenges to me. But the good thing about it is it's brought the challenges, but it's also created the space by forcing my routine to be changed it's actually created the space that I needed to then address some of the challenges and embrace them. And it's been really cool. So for me, I've done things that I haven't otherwise, wouldn't normally have sort of made myself do, got myself to do. And like I've seen other people all doing the same thing. So in the life of the church, I mean, we saw you guys go on cameras the first time ever. It was the beginning of lockdown. And so it's just been really good to see people do, you know, stretch out and do things. It's actually brought about a really healthy growth in a lot of us. Yeah.
So before this season, everyone was living their normal lives. Then lockdown happened, then that was the new normal lives. Now restrictions are changing, and now it's another new normal. But moving forward in this season and beyond this, what does it look like for Enjoy Church in this next chapter?
Well, that's a great question. What does it look like beyond the now? I would say to you, Aaron, it's going to be same, same, but different.
Awesome. Yeah.
And you might be like, same, same, but different. It's like nothing is the same. No, there's a lot of things the same. We need to remember, and I'd encourage us all to remember, that what makes us the people of God isn't a service on Sunday morning.
Yeah.
So the services have changed. That's true. But fundamentally, who we are hasn't changed, and it's not going to change.
Yeah.
What makes us the people of God isn't a service, but what makes us the people of God is our convictions, our revelation, our beliefs, and our values, and they haven't changed at all.
Yeah.
So while a lot of things have changed in regard to service and how or when, in essence, who we are hasn't changed at all.
Yeah.
So as much as I believe in corporate worship, and you know I do, I cannot wait, I promise you, I cannot wait, church, to get back to meetings with 100 in them or 500 in them or 1,000 in them again. I can't wait for those days to return. But in the meantime, I would encourage us all to make the most of the opportunity we have, because we actually have an incredible opportunity.
Sure.
I was speaking to my neighbours recently about some works that they want to do next door, and I said, well, if you pass me the lemons over the fence, I'll make lemonade out of them. What do I mean by that? What I mean by that is none of us would have asked for this situation or these circumstances to come our way, but they've come our way. So what are we going to do? We can either retreat and live a life of fear, or we can rise up in faith and be the people that God has called us to be and make the best lemonade in the world out of the lemons that are being handed our way.
Yes.
So just let me speak to every enjoyer just for a moment. And maybe you're watching in today and you're not an enjoyer yet, and you're like, man, I wish I had a family like that. Well, as in, you can be part of a family like this. And I just want to take a moment to speak to every enjoyer, and for that matter, anyone who may be leaning in thinking, I'd like to be part of a church environment like this one. So what I want to say to every enjoyer is simply this. Next Sunday, I want to encourage all of you, because obviously you're online today, you're watching online, but next Sunday, can I encourage all of you to make it your endeavor, make it your desire to reach out and then step into another home or have people come into your home. What I would ask of all of you is that you watch the service with a group of people, you gather together and you watch with others. Let me say this, there's no doubt about it. A lot of people are saying, I can watch service anytime, and there is no doubt you can, absolute no doubt about that. But I want to encourage you, because the reality is this, a service is something you watch, but fellowship is something you experience.
Yeah.
And you and I, we all know, as we are starting to come back together, the fellowship factor is amazing. It's like, I think we've all enjoyed Zoom. It has met a need, and it will continue to play a part in all of that we do moving forward. But there is nothing like true fellowship. When brothers and sisters gather together, look each other in the eye, laugh, connect, engage. I've walked into a few meetings recently over the last week, and I promise you, you can feel the spirit of the room before you actually get there.
Yeah.
You can hear the laughter. You walk in, you sense the joy. You see the facial expressions as people see you come in, and they're delighted to see you and delighted to see each other. I got to tell you, there is nothing like it. In that place, there is a spirit. There is an atmosphere. The presence of God is real. I want to encourage you and remind you of what the scripture says in Matthew 18, verse 20. This is Jesus speaking. He says, for where two or three have gathered together in my name, I am there in their midst.
Yeah.
I love this verse because it really speaks about the power of gathering.
Yeah.
You're not going to get the same feeling, the same emotion, the same presence of God if you're there by yourself. There is something that is supernatural and spiritual, very spiritual, that occurs where two or three people gather together. And this is why moving forward, we're going to be asking all of you, if you're an enjoyer, if you consider yourself an enjoyer, please work with us. It's our responsibility to look after you spiritually. And we are asking you now to work with us in this place. We're going to ask you to gather in friendship groups. We're going to ask you to gather in departments. Now, I know when I say departments, some of you are thinking, but we have 150 people in our department. That's right. You can cut it up into 10 groups of 15, just like that.
Absolutely.
So now we've got friendship groups meeting, we've got departments meeting, maybe we've got families meeting, maybe there's a group of families that want to meet. You can have 20 people in your room, so we're going to, or in your house, so we're going to encourage you, gather together and be like iron sharpening iron.
Not physically.
Sorry?
Not physically.
Not physically. No, social distancing does still apply. Social distancing does apply. Remember, 1.5 metres, praise ye the Lord. All right, so we want to keep that right, no doubt about that. And so, but moving forward, we can gather together. I want to encourage you, that, even if you're not part of a friendship group or not part of a department, maybe you can gather in a host home. But if you're not part of a friendship group or a department, you can just join a host family and watch Enjoy at Home. It's going to be an incredible opportunity. We have an opportunity here to step into each other's space. We need to remember we are the body of Christ. When you were born again, you were born again by the Spirit of God, and you were supernaturally, spiritually joined to the body. We need each other. So I'm going to encourage all of you and you to make sure you're with someone else next Sunday watching Enjoy Church.
Pastor Shane, you already have people coming over this Sunday, don't you?
That's right. Even as we are, you are hearing this today, obviously Sunday, but this Sunday, we've actually got people in our house as well. And the reason is because at the moment we can have five. And it's like, well, if we can have five, I've reached out to five people and said, I want you to come and have brunch with us, watch the service with us. Let's have some fellowship together. It is good for us. Yeah. This isn't a sermon. This is our life. Yeah. And I want to encourage you, make it your life as well. Yeah.
Good. Fellowship factor, hey?
Fellowship. Cool. We all need it. Emily, we all need it.
Fellowship factor, so good. Yeah. So, Pastor Georgie, for us as Enjoy, what does this next chapter look like for us?
That's a really good question. I just know all I know is it's going to be awesome. Yeah. It's going to be amazing. Yeah. I'm really excited because I just think God has brought us to this place. You know, we often think the coronavirus has brought us to this place, but in actual fact, God has brought us to this place. And he's taking us into a new season. So I think it's going to have a bit of the old and a bit of the new, because obviously there are things that we don't want to lose. There are foundational things, fundamental things that we don't want to lose, like gathering together. But then we've had all this new stuff that we've had to learn how to do, whether it be technology or learning new skills, doing different things that we haven't had to do. Yeah. I think God wants us to not leave that behind now, but actually bring it in. And I think it's going to be amazing. It's going to be an incredible season.
It is going to be great.
And this next question I have, I think everyone's going to agree with me with this at home, is that Pastor Shane can get very excited. So I want to ask you, what are you excited about?
Well, it's true, I can get excited. Not just about the Mighty Tigers who are going to be playing next week, but anyway, beating Collingwood probably by 19 points would be my prediction. But there's a whole lot more. When it comes to Enjoy World, I got to tell you, I am so excited. What I love, even in this season, people have still been coming to Christ. I don't know about anybody else. There's nothing I get more excited about than that. Yeah, Richmond's playing, but Richmond comes, Richmond goes. But you know what? The kingdom is going to last forever. And when people get saved and are born again by the Spirit of God, become part of the kingdom of God, their eternal future is set. And so I have loved the fact that during this season we are still seeing people come to Christ. We had this week, because people are coming to Christ, we still have new Christian classes running via Zoom. This week in Hobart, it was amazing because this week in Hobart, they're having their new Christians class, and it came around to the Holy Spirit and the baptism of the Holy Spirit. This week in Hobart, eight people received the Holy Spirit via Zoom in Hobart. Can you not get excited about that? Yeah. Oh, my Lord, I could get excited. Next Sunday, this is what's happening next Sunday. All right, let's get excited now. Next Sunday, we're going to have water baptisms. And you're like, for real? Absolutely. It's like, where are we doing that? Well, we're going to do it in our West location. Here's the thing. Some of you would have seen on social media this week, people are baptizing people in their pools. And it's like, it's out of control. And it's like, some people are like, Are we allowed to do that? I don't know. But I think we are. But don't tell anybody. Jesus, whatever. It's like, can you imagine, as in John the Baptist is down there baptizing people in the river and anyway, well, we won't go there. All right. But here's the thing. So we saw on social media, and so there is a need. We realize we have a need to be baptizing people now because people are coming to Christ. They want to be water baptized. So next Sunday at 10:45, there's going to be a baptismal service in the West. If you want to be water baptized, I want to encourage you, reach out to your location pastor or one of your leaders from your location, or you can watch the email address coming up on the screen right now, and you can email straight to that address and you'll be able to ask, how do I get water baptized? Someone is going to get back to you, probably Pastor Tammy, but whatever. Here's the thing, people are getting water baptized. I can't help but get excited. Now, there's all sorts of people being water baptized, but you know what? It goes on from there. During this season of lockdown, why am I excited? As in, during this season of lockdown, you know what we've done? You know what you've done? This is what we have done. We have planted Enjoy Church Phnom Penh. And it's like, for years, this has been a thought. It has been back here. It's been, it's like, imagine. Yeah. In fact, in our vision offering last year, you would have seen lots of imagery about Cambodia. Now it's planted. Literally, the amount of people leaning in is incredible. We have all sorts of worship happening coming out of Phnom Penh. It's amazing what God is doing. Here's the exciting part, though. So we are now streaming an Enjoy Church service in Khmer into Phnom Penh. But here's the thing. How many of you know the worldwide net web thing? It doesn't know boundaries of nations. And so people from Melbourne have been watching our Cambodian service, which is in Khmer, and now we have people in Melbourne who are watching that service that is for those people who want to get baptised next Sunday morning in the West location. And it's like, how is this happening? It's a miracle, and God is moving by His Spirit. I'm just so excited about it. I'm excited about our Melton building going up. Praise God. Yes. It's like, as in the timing is in the hands of the Lord. Yeah. But it is going up, and it's going to be completed. I'm super excited about that. We have works going on in Adelaide in the community section of that church. It is just amazing what God is doing. So there is so much happening. There is so much to be excited about. And I look at all these things and you know, Aaron and Emily, you work very closely with me. Raymond, I know you want to keep praying. Your day is coming. And so, but the reality is this, you know, our world, everything that's going on, it is unbelievable. And I know I look at you, but I can look into that camera and I see every location. I see every member. I see the households, the families, everyone that's represented. And together we are doing something great. I'm excited.
Yeah.
It's
awesome.
Oh, it's great days ahead, isn't it? I'm so excited.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
You can't be around this table and not be excited.
Pastor Georgie, what would you say you're excited about in this next season?
Well, I've got a feeling that Shane's kind of probably pretty much taken everything I was going to say.
I'm sorry, but that's why I put myself first.
That's right, exactly. But I'm just excited. I just think the future is big, the future is bright, and I just know that God is doing great things. And I love the thought that God hasn't, the gospel has not had a lid put on it. The people of God have not had a lid put on them, but we are still out there. We're still reaching people. Yeah. Jesus is still touching people. It's incredible. So with everything that's happening, it's going to be, as I said before, I think a little bit of the old, a little bit of the new. Yeah. God's going to show us a whole new, exciting way to combine these together and to make it into something that's even more powerful and more effective, which is really cool. So things will be changing, but in a good way. We're just thinking, you know, like friendship groups are changing, locations, the way we do that will probably be changing, all kinds of things. Summit, what do you think Summit's going to be like next year? Like that's
That's
crazy.
Crazy.
What was that? Who knows? But you know what I mean.
Praise God. There's a Cambodian coming out right there.
Yeah.
It's, what do I think Summit is going to look like? That's a great question, because what we do know is that, and you've heard me say it already, that I don't, maybe I didn't say it, but I've said it everywhere else, that we will never go back to the way things were. We're going to go on to what will be. Yeah. I really hope that Summit this year we're all able to gather together.
Yeah.
But even if we can't, we will be doing Summit one way or the other. I think that what this has taught us is that we just need to continue to seek the Lord. I think it's interesting that speaking about the sons of Issachar, the Bible says that they understood the times and knew what Israel should do. And I really do believe that in this season, by the wisdom that comes from the Holy Spirit and the leading of the Holy Spirit, we've known what to do in the season. And so when it comes to Summit, I'm too sure what it's going to look like. I really hope we can all gather together in one place. But if we can't, we'll be coming to you. But if we can, we will be. So it's going to be a bit of this and a bit of that. We're just going to go on the journey and see what God does. It's very exciting. The future is exciting.
Well, thank you, Pastor Shane and Georgie, for today. That was incredible. And for everyone at home, next week is the week we can meet in groups of 20. It's going to be so much fun to hang out with you all. Yeah. If you don't have an Enjoy home to go to, why don't you find one? Why don't you register for one as well and host one and have people over and eat lots of food together? It's going to be great.
Yes.
But right now, Pastor Shane, I just wanted to ask you, what would you like to say to people who may be watching today who don't have a relationship with God the Father?
That's right. And the truth is, there's probably many people that are watching in today that it just hasn't come together yet. And I get it. You know my story. I grew up in the church, but I wasn't of the church. Mm. Everyone thought I was of the church because I was in the church, but it's not necessarily so. And I would think today across so many homes and so many places, there'd be people that are watching in and you know of God, you've been around God, you've been in church, you've been around church, but to this point in time, maybe you haven't accepted Jesus Christ to be your Lord and Saviour. Can I encourage you, take the step. It'll be the greatest thing you ever do. I spent all my teenage years in church and God was so close, and yet the reality is he was so far. And I think, to be honest, that for people who stay in that place for too long, it actually becomes a very unhappy place because you know the reality of God, but you're not enjoying the fullness of God, and it's a bad place to be in. I want to encourage every man, every woman, remember what the scripture says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever would believe in him would not perish but would have eternal life. I know some of you have heard people say that if you were to walk into a church, the roof would fall in. Friend, I want to encourage you today. The church was birthed for men and women just like you and just like me. We all have a past. We all have a history. But Jesus doesn't judge us on that. He understands that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. He came for us all, and he has made a way so that everyone can come back into relationship with the Father. So if you're out there today and you're saying, Shane, today's the day. I've watched in on this scenario. I've watched in on this meeting today, this service today, and I see a joy and I see a life and I see a love that I want in my life. Friend, I tell you the truth, it comes in no other name other than the name of Jesus. We love Enjoy Church, but you won't find this just in Enjoy Church by itself. It's not enough. You need Jesus. You'll be able to find this at Enjoy Church, but you need Jesus to be part of the family. Today's the day. I want to encourage you, if you want to receive salvation today, if you want to receive forgiveness today, if you want to receive love like you've never experienced before, receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Saviour. So here's the thing, as you're watching online, if you're watching on our online platform today, there's a little hand on the bottom right-hand side there that says, I want to give my life to Jesus. Maybe you're watching on Facebook. Can I encourage you, if you're out there today watching on Facebook, just write, if you want to give your life to Jesus today, just write, I want to give my life to Jesus. Just write it in there in the comments. It'll come up and someone from that location is going to reach out to you. Hit that little raised hand if you're on our online platform today and someone is going to reach out to you. Friends, I encourage you, it's the best decision you can ever make. So right now, if you want to give your life to Christ, hit that little raised hand, right? I want to give my life to Jesus on Facebook, and it's going to start you on a journey. But you know what we're going to do together? We are going to pray. I want to pray for you right here, right now. We're all going to pray together all over the world. People are praying, enjoyers are praying for you as you give your life to Christ today. So let's pray together. Yeah. Dear Jesus,
I thank you today
for bringing me to this place.
For bringing me to this place.
That I might give my life to you.
That I might give my life to you.
Today, Jesus.
I give you my life.
And I give you my all.
I give you my all.
I ask you, Jesus.
I ask you, Jesus,
to forgive me of my sin.
To forgive me of my sin.
And help me, Lord,
to live a life
that's pleasing.
That's pleasing.
And honoring of you.
Today, Jesus.
I give you my life.
I give you my
all. I give you my all.
I give you my all.
And I believe.
From this day on.
You are my Father.
You are my Father.
My Lord.
My Lord.
My Savior.
Savior,
and my friend,
and my friend,
and from this day on,
I'm
your child,
and
I'll never be alone again. In Jesus' wonderful name,
amen.
Come on, everybody, let's give it up for all those who just gave their hearts to Christ.
So
now, here's the thing, Kidmania is about to come on, but before we flick across to there, once again, I want to remind you, if you're an enjoyer, here's my challenge to you. find someone to be watching Enjoy Church online with next week. It's the fellowship. There's power in fellowship. Yeah. When you come together, something supernatural is about to occur. You're going to feel love. You're going to feel the presence of God. You will laugh because you're enjoyers, and you will eat because you're enjoyers. Brunch. Praise God for brunch. When we get to heaven, brunch is the only meal we're going to have all day long. We're going to have brunch in the morning, brunch at lunchtime, brunch in dinner time, brunch, smash dabo for everyone. God bless you, lights. Have a great day. We'll see you soon.
Wow, how amazing was that? I love our church. Coming up shortly, we've got our Kid Mania segment, but before we go there, I just want to encourage you to do a few things. The first thing is to make sure that you're following Enjoy Church on both Facebook and Instagram. That way, you're being kept up to date with what's coming up at Enjoy Church. The other thing is to make sure that that you subscribe to the YouTube, Enjoy Church's YouTube channel, because we've always got some great content and fresh content coming on there, and it's going to help you, it's going to bless you, it's going to bless your family. So church, we pray that you had a blessed day. Have a great rest of the Sunday. And right now, let's go Kid Mania!
Hey kids, and welcome to Kid Mania Online. We are so excited to have you here with us. We are going to have so much fun. Parents of young kids, can I encourage you to download the Bible app for kids? It is an incredible resource for you. And don't forget to visit the Enjoy Church website and download our app, where you'll find more great resources for you and your family. We'll be the light in the darkness, so all may see.
we're going for you. These four walls won't hold us, hold us. We're going for you. These four walls won't hold us, hold us. We're going for you. These four walls won't hold us, hold us. We're going for you. These four walls won't hold us, hold us. We're going for you. These four walls won't hold us, hold us. We'll be the light in the darkness, so all may see, all may see. We'll live our lives in your likeness, so all may feel your heartbeat, your heartbeat.
Hey kids, you know, we have an amazing opportunity that God has given us. He has given us the opportunity to have the life that He had planned for us. Now, what kind of life is that? It's an amazing life. It's a fantastic life. It's a fun life. It's a journey. And in the Bible, the Apostle Paul says that our life is like a race. What kind of race, you might be thinking? Is it a sprint where you run very, very quickly as hard as you can and it's over in a flash? I don't think so. I think the kind of life that God had planned for us, it's more like a long distance cross-country marathon where there's hills and dips and there's times when we can run fast and there's times when we have to slow it down. But most importantly, it's not over in a flash. It's a long, long race. Did you know people that decide to run a marathon, they don't just wake up one day and say, hey, I've got a bright idea. I'm going to run a marathon today. They know that to run a marathon, it's not a small deal, it's a big deal. A marathon on average is 42 kilometers long. I know if I decided to run a marathon, the first thing I would do would be maybe to run 1 kilometer and then build up to maybe 4 kilometers and then 10 kilometers and then 20 kilometers. And then one day perhaps I could run 42 kilometers, but I wouldn't straight away go, okay, I'm gonna run 42 kilometers because I know that my body needs to train. Also, I would make sure that I'm wearing the right equipment. I wanna make sure that my clothes are light, that they're not weighing me down, because I wanna make sure that whatever I'm doing, that I'm prepared to run the race well. Paul gives us wisdom in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, where it says, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, let us throw off every weight that slows us down and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Well, kids, we're going to break down this scripture. It starts off by saying, therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great crowd of witnesses to the life of faith. The first thing I want to make sure we're doing is that we are running our race for Jesus. We're not running for anyone else. I don't know about you, but when someone's watching, I want to do better. Did you know Jesus is watching? God the Father is watching? All the angels in heaven are watching, and they're watching your life and they want you to do well. They're hoping that you're going to do well. They're wanting you to do your best in running this race. So let's run the best way we can, not for other people, but for Jesus. Going back to the verse, it says, let us throw off every weight that slows us down and the sin that so easily entangles. So kids, we need to get rid of the weight. Get rid of the weight. As you can see, I've got weight on my wrists, I've got a weight vest, and let me tell you, it is not light. It is pretty heavy. Now, if I was just wearing these weights for just a couple of minutes, it wouldn't be such a big deal. But if I had to wear these weights every single day, when I wake up, when I come into the office, when I'm trying to do my normal exercise, when I'm playing with my kids, it would feel so annoying and so heavy and make me so tired. You know what? We're never meant to carry weight, at least not for a long, long time. Because every time we carry weight, sometimes the simplest things seem so much harder. Could you imagine always having to brush your teeth with weights on your arms? That's crazy. But sometimes we carry weight. Sometimes when we live life, we pick up weight that we never meant to pick up. Sometimes we pick up weights when someone hurts us, when people call us names, when they spread lies about us and we believe them. Sometimes we're carrying weight. When someone hurts us and we don't forgive them, we're also carrying weight. When we do what we know we shouldn't do, that's sinning, we carry weight. And so God has called us not to carry weight. He's called us to get rid of the weight. He said, throw off every weight that holds you down, that slows you down. Because God wants you to run the race well. He wants you to run the race without having the weight. So right now, I'm gonna get rid of these weights. So, that one came off pretty easy. I'm gonna try and get rid of this one. Sometimes the weights, they try and tangle you up. They try and just, you try and get rid of them and they try and just stay onto you, but you need to get rid of all the weight. Okay. Okay, got that one off. And you know what, I am feeling good. My arms feel so light, but I've got some more weight I need to get rid of. Let's get rid of this weight. That was so good. I feel so much better, so much lighter, and I'm ready to run the race that God had planned for me. Well, kids, I know two people that are great examples of how to run the race well. We've got Pastor Shane and Pastor Georgie, and they're gonna join us in today's Game Time. It's game time.
Here we go.
Kids, what a great game segment with Pastor Shane and Pastor Georgie. They both did fantastic playing Mario Kart. Did you know that Pastor Georgie, in the practice runs, she actually won those races? But today, Pastor Shane, you are the winner. So let's go back to what we've been learning about today, running our race. The first thing that we need to do is run for Jesus. The second thing we need to do is make sure that we are getting rid of the weight. And now let's go back to our verse for our third point, where it says, and let us run with perseverance. Kids, can you please say this along with me? Never, ever, ever give up. Never give up. Never stop running the race that God has marked out for you. Did you know in the race of life, you can never lose if you don't stop running? So can I encourage you to never stop running? God wants you to run in such a way that you will finish the race. Doesn't matter if you start bad, doesn't matter if you fall over or you trip over, you can always pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and keep running. Just keep running towards that finish line and never ever give up. Going back to our scripture for our last point, it says in the verse, the race marked out for us. You know, we need to run the race that is marked out for us, and there are two ways we can do this. First of all, don't compare yourself with anyone else. You know, sometimes when you're running a race, you can be tempted to look to your left and look to your right and see how everyone else is doing running their race. You know what, don't worry about anyone else. You know what, you're a terrible version of someone else, but you're a perfect version of you. So don't try and be like someone else and how they're running their race. Don't copy them. Be the best you that God has called you to be. And the next thing we can do is make sure we're staying on track, that we're staying on the path that God has marked out for us. When I was a kid, I used to do some cross-country running. Now, I didn't run very often, but when I did, I found it very, very difficult. Because when you're running cross-country, there are a lot of hills, and hills make running so much harder. And so what I decided to do is I decided to take a shortcut. You know what, kids? There really is no such thing as a shortcut. Because on that shortcut, it turned out that I faced so many dead ends, and I had to take the long way to get back on the right track. And so instead of taking a shortcut, I ended up running for an extra hour more than I should have. You know what? We don't want to take any shortcuts, because in life there is no such thing as a shortcut to what God has for you. God wants you to stay on track. God wants to make sure that you're running the race that He has marked out for you. Let me tell you, kids, if you stay on track and you stick to the path that God has for you, you can never lose. Okay, kids, let's go over what we've just learned. First of all, we want to run for Jesus. Second, let's make sure that we get rid of all the weight. Third of all, we want to make sure that we run with perseverance. Don't give up. And the fourth thing we need to do is make sure that we don't compare ourselves with others and don't take shortcuts. Kids, I hope you have fun running your race. How about we quickly pray together? Lord God, I want to thank you for every young person and every family out there, and I just want to pray that you would bless them as they run their race. I pray that you would give them the faith and give them the strength, Lord, and the wisdom to run their race the way you've called them to, so that they can win and finish strong. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Thanks for tuning in to Kidmania Online. We hope you have an amazing week full of faith and fun, because at Kidmania, that's who we are.